Here at iFixit, it's our mission to teach the world how to fix everything, and one of the most important ways we can do that is by making sure all the repair guides on iFixit are in as many languages as possible. Today, I'm going to show you how you can pitch in and help make our repair guides available to everyone in the world. Before we begin, make sure to log into your account on iFixit.com and select the language you wish to translate into. If you don't have a specific guide or wiki in mind, we have some recommendations for the most needed translations over at iFixit.com/translate. You can easily navigate there by clicking on Help Translate iFixit in the footer of all our pages. On iFixit.com/translate, we display a list of popular pages which would be most relevant to translate to your language. You can sort the list by guides or wikis. Once you've found a page that matches your language skills, simply click on the link to be taken to the translation interface. In the guide view, click the Translate button on the top. You'll automatically be taken to the translation interface. If the guide you're translating has any prerequisites, they will automatically be displayed on top, together with a note as to whether the translation is already done or still incomplete. In the case of incomplete translation of prerequisite guides, we strongly recommend translating those first. Under Guide Information, you'll find all relevant details in the source language on the left, as well as empty fields for your translation into the target language on the right. You may use the option to copy the current text to your translation using the arrows if that helps, or you can just type in your translation in the empty fields. Using the copy arrow can be particularly helpful in the case of a long device name or model number which don't need to change in the target language. The title should clearly convey what the guide will show, but you're welcome to step away from literal translation towards more clarity in the target language if needed. Make sure to check that your translated title includes the device's name, component, and the guide type, such as replacement or repair. As soon as you've entered your translation, the red incomplete icon will change to the green done icon, while any field you're currently working on will have a yellow bullet. If you want to know more about making your translation easy to find on Google, take a look at our wiki on translating guides and wikis. The introduction field should explain everything your reader should know before attempting the repair. If you come across any mistakes in the source language, please first go to the guide in the source language and make changes there before you go on translating. Otherwise, your translation will be flagged outdated once errors are corrected in the source language. Next, check the conclusion. By default, each guide concludes with, "To reassemble your device, follow these instructions in the reverse order." If you're not yet familiar with the standard phrase corresponding to this one in your target language, browse some of the other guides to find it, and keep the translations throughout the site consistent. You don't have to reinvent the wheel each time. Finally, remember to hit Save Changes. Scrolling down will reveal the guide steps section. From here, you can click on the arrow next to each incomplete guide step and start adding the translations. To add your translation, simply click the Insert Translation Here text and fill out your translation. Again, you may wish to use the arrow in order to copy over the source text to the translation. This is especially useful as it copies over the formatting such as indented bullets, colored bullets matching markups in the photos, and special bullets. Don't forget to also add translation for the step title if there is one, and remember to click Save when you're finished. If you're translating a guide from scratch and not editing or completing an already existing translation, you can comfortably move on to the next step by clicking on the Next Step button on the top right corner. Once you've translated all the steps of your guide, you're ready to see what it looks like in your language. Click on View and QA your own translation. You can always return to the translate screen by clicking on the translate button on the top of your guide. One last note, if you see a banner appear on the guide that says, "This guide has more recent changes, switch to the latest unverified version," you should probably wait a few days. Someone else might have already suggested a translation, which you could accidentally overrule if you enter yours. We hope this helps. If you have any questions, please email us at translate@ifixit.com. Happy translating!